every GeneXus object, we can define variables based on simple data types or structured data types that allow us to store an entity's data. For example, a numeric value, a text, or a country's details. In addition, we can indicate that the variable we're defining of a certain data type is actually a collection of elements of this type. Collections behave in a similar way, regardless of the data type of their elements. In order to work with them, several functions are available to facilitate their use. We've seen some of them, such as sort, to order the collection, or the forIn command to run through it. Now let's take a look at a few more. Suppose that we've created a countries variable of SDT country type and set it as a collection using the checkbox in the isCollection column. Every element in the collection will be of SDT country type. The SDT hasn't been defined as a collection, so it only allows us to store data about a single country. However, since we've defined a variable of this type and set it as a collection, we will be able to store data about many countries. If we insert the country's collection variable in a piece of code and type a period, we will see its properties and methods. Let's examine the most frequently used ones. The count property allows us to know the number of elements in the collection. The add method allows us to add an element to the collection. The remove method allows us to remove an element based on its index. And if we want to delete all the elements from the collection, we use the clear method. There are other interesting methods or properties that we won't mention here, but that you can read about in this link.